okie dokie, artichokies, last frickin' sample of the day. I would always be in the mood for this. Like, anytime, any place, wherever you want, with whoever you want. You know what I'm saying? Know what I'm saying? It's no regrets. Know what I'm saying? Hey everybody, welcome back to Whisky Central. If you're new here, my name is Shayla, and today we have a sample that I'm probably never going to own a bottle of. I'm going to nose it, taste it, give my thoughts on it in a short review format. Okay, guys. Last sample of the day. That means you know how deep I am now. Okay, this is Lagavulin 11 Nick Offerman Edition, finished in Guinness casks. Hallelujah. 46% ABV. This sample was given to me by Stacy H. She has a channel called Four Leaf Whiskey. If you haven't checked it out, go check it out. We're just going for it. I haven't tasted this in a while, and I'm ready for it. All right, details on this whiskey. This bottle running about $150. Yikes. This is an Isla peated whiskey. It's 46% ABV, 11 years old. It's finished in ex Guinness casks. All right, that's about all you need to know on this bad boy. Let's go on the nose. So it smells like a peated whiskey. So if you don't like peated whiskey, don't buy this, but it smells peated, toned way down. It's like the knob went from 10 to like 2, and it smells so much like chocolate, oak and chocolate, and just deliciousness, basically. Peat dial went from 10 to 2 to now it's like at a 5. Yeah, there's a beautiful amount of vanilla, some spice. I feel like would be a good dessert whiskey. I don't know if it's just because of the chocolate, maybe even a little bit of like an apricot. It's mostly like chocolatey kind of richness though. There is a little bit of like a bright fruit character that kind of cuts through a little bit. We're going on the palate. I don't care if I can get more on the nose. Let's go. Woo! Oh, she hits you. That's much peatier than I expected. The nose, it's dialed down so much and you get that like Guinness cask chocolatey deliciousness. It tastes much more, at least first sip, Lagavulin, almost like a little bit like a lechik. Like it's got that kind of smoked eel. But yeah, it like tastes like a Lagavulin, but kind of muted a little bit. It's still on my palate. Like it's gonna hang out for forever. It's got peat on it, so much more balanced on the second sip. First sip, I was like, woo, this is a lot of Lagavulin. Second sip, you get a little bit of chocolate, quite a bit of barrel spice. I don't know, the texture, just kind of everything plays a little bit more than 46, which is awesome. Peated Isla, classic vibes, you know? But then it has a little bit of that sweetness from kind of the vanilla, a little bit of that chocolate. I think it balances really well. I know this is my last dram of the day, so, you know, a little Shay Lammered, but I could drink this all day. Like, I haven't had a sip for a long time. And now it's like, went from kind of chocolate, spice, tiny bit, a little bit of bitterness. And now it's like smoked meat. Oh, it's like going from chocolate to orange chocolate, tiny bit bitter. And now it's like in a coffee direction. I love my life so freaking much. Okay, it says we're on low battery. Let's see if I can get my thoughts out before it dies. Price, is this worth the money? I have never spent $150 on a whiskey. If I saw this, I would buy this bottle. $150 is a lot. I don't necessarily think it's, I don't know if it's worth it or not. And $150 is steep. Like, I wish it was like $100. But I get why it's that expensive. One, Nick Offerman. Two, Guinness casks. You know, it's just, it is what it is. And then on top of it, it's Lagavulin. Lagavulin's kind of getting up there in price. So if you can find this for $150 and you like stout beer and you like Lagavulin, you're probably gonna love this. It's great. I don't think the Guinness casks overpower the Lagavulin spirit character, which I was kind of concerned about when she sent this to me. I thought, oh man, is it gonna be, I mean, I love Guinness, so I'm not gonna be too upset, but is it gonna overpower? And it does not at all. It beautifully balances with it, and it's friggin' awesome. So have you tried Lagavulin 11 Nick Offerman Edition, finished in Guinness casks? If you have, did you like it? Did you think it was worth the money? Let me know in the comment section down below. All right, that about does it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed this short review. If you did, leave it a like. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you with another one of these in a couple of days. It, you know, just depends on what floats your boat. Literally and figuratively. Okay, also a question. If you've had this, if this was a song, what would it be?
Elle dit qu'il n'est jamais très loin, qu'il part très souvent travailler. Maman dit travailler c'est bien, bien mieux qu'être mal accompagné. Pas vrai, où est ton papa?
Okay, if we were a sea shanty, what would we be? Let's see. Where is my sea shanty playlist? I need it right now.
I gained a day away, Santiana. Heave her up and away we'll go away, Santiana. Heave her up and away we'll go along the plains of Mexico. She's a fast clipper ship and a bully good crew. Away, Santiana. And an old salty yank for a captain too. Along the plains of Mexico. Heave her up and away we'll go. Away, Santiana. Heave her up and away we'll go. Along the plains of Mexico.
Yes.